We're also getting some breaking news right now. AIIMS has released a statement saying that any information on the report submitted by Dr. Gupta should be obtained from the CBI. So in a way, AIIMS is not really responding on questions about the medical panel's report in the Sushant case or what has now happened after Republic's broadcast. The flip-flops of Dr. Sudhir Gupta, who heads their medical panel, the AIIMS is basically telling media that they should go to the CBI instead to obtain any information on what Dr. Sudhir Gupta has said in its report or otherwise. Abhishek Kapoor, my colleague, is also joining us for more on this. Abhishek.
Well, Shivani, this is one way of looking at it, that the AIIMS has actually washed its hands off Dr. Sudhir Gupta in saying that the communication was directly by the CBI to Dr. Gupta, and that he constituted the board, and then the report has been given back to the CBI. And since it's a legal matter, all the inputs on the report have to be obtained from the CBI and not from AIIMS. Because of the fact that all day it is the name of AIIMS that has been taken in terms of Dr. Sudhir Gupta's association with them, this statement clearly reflects some discomfiture perhaps in the management of the of the institution, and that's why this is a statement where they say that it is between Dr. Gupta and CBI so far as the writing of the report was concerned, and now that the report is with the CBI, let the CBI speak for itself, because now it's a CBI property.
Yes, but would it be so easy for AIIMS to just completely, you know, wash their hands off? Because it is, at the end of the day, the premier institute in the country, and they are also looked upon as an institute and as an authority, quite like the CBI itself. In fact, I am also joined by Aniket Nigam, advocate, on the show. Aniket, let me take this to you. The AIIMS is saying that you please go to CBI to get to know any information on what Dr. Sudhir Gupta's panel report is. But the institute itself also will have some accountability here, isn't it?
Of course, Shivani, AIIMS cannot pass the buck in such a manner. Let's not forget the fact that on 22nd of August, Dr. Gupta spoke with your senior journalist and told him that the crime scene was contaminated, the postmortem report was defective, the postmortem was not conducted in the manner it should have been. And when he was of the prima facie opinion on 22nd of August that this entire autopsy itself is in shadow of doubt, in such a situation, how did he now arrive at a conclusive opinion that this is a case of hanging? That's number one. Number two, when this expose has come out on record and everybody is watching this in our country today, it is very imperative for a premier institution like AIIMS to come out and clarify their stand on this. They cannot simply say that it is for CBI to take a call on it, because it is the medical officer of AIIMS who has gone on record on 22nd of August and has expressed his doubts on the manner in which the autopsy of Sushant Singh was conducted.
Right, right.
So certainly AIIMS cannot behave
right.
in
so
such
in other
manner.
Words, there will of course be questions on AIIMS too, because at the end of the day, it is their panel that is looked upon in certain cases to provide a medico-legal opinion and reports. But at the same time, all eyes will be of course on the CBI to come out and tell the public as to what they make of this report, what their next stage of investigation is going to be. We'll leave it at that. Aniket and Prakash, thanks a lot for joining us for the meantime.